Hi, Ed Friedland, the Bass Whisperer here, and I'm very happy to show you all the new G&L Mj4 bass. While the Mj4 is a new model for G&L, it's based on their popular JB2 instrument. It's been around for quite a while. The main difference being that the JB2 is a passive instrument and the pickups are traditional single-coil J style, whereas the Mj4, it's active, features the new M-series preamp, and the pickups, while they may look like straight-ahead jazz pickups, they are G&L's new bi-coil Alnico 5 split-coil J pickups for hum-free operation. This particular Mj4 has a lightweight swamp ash body and a beautiful honey burst finish. The Mj4 comes specced with G&L's number 8 neck, which has a 1.5 nut width, which is standard for a jazz bass. But this particular instrument came in with a number 12 neck, which has the 1.625 nut width. It's a little bit wider. It's a nice in-between between a jazz and a P-neck. I would liken it to, say, a B-neck on a 70s P-bass. It's not quite as round in the back. It's a little flatter, which gives a nice comfort. The fingerboard has a 12-inch radius, which is a little bit flatter than your standard vintage 7.5-inch radius. The very attractive rosewood fingerboard has 21 medium jumbo frets, and like all US G&L instruments, the instrument is plecked to perfection. This particular one came in with the quarter sawn neck option, which besides that the grain is beautiful, it's also a little more stable. They gave the maple neck and headstock a slight vintage tint. It's a real pretty thing. It's purely cosmetic, but you know, it just makes it look kind of cool. At this point, I'd say most people know what to expect from an active J-bass type instrument. It's not a new platform, but for G&L it's significant in that it's their first active J-bass. And they went out and they designed a preamp and pickup system specifically for this instrument, and I think they've done a really great job. The M-Series Jazz preamp is very well tuned to these particular pickups. You get plus or minus 14 dB at 40 Hz for the bass control, plus or minus 12 dB at 600 Hz for the mid-range, and the treble gives you plus or minus 14 dB in the 8K range. I'm going to play some fingerstyle with the tone control set completely flat, both pickups straight up in the middle. I'm going to add some bottom. Add a little bit more. As you can hear, it gets really plump. Now let's check out the mid-range. Again, I'm going to go flat. Now some mids. The 600 Hz, I think it's a really nice spot for these particular pickups because it brings in a presence in the mid-range. It's not quite high enough to get nasal, but it's high enough to kind of help poke it through the mix a bit. Of course, blended with some bass sounds great. Here's flat again. I'm going to add some bass and some mids. It's getting better and better. I'm going to roll a little bit of the treble off just to darken it up, make it a real vintage. Okay, we're back to flat now. Let's hear the treble boost. Again, this is flat. Let's add some treble. Obviously, It's pretty bright, but that's kind of the idea. It goes both ways. You can boost and cut. Let me boost a little bit more. Now by itself, that's an awful lot of high end, but if we support that with a little low end, some lows and some highs, I'm going to roll some mids in with that, and we'll get all three up a little bit. That's a beautiful thing. Another thing I really like about the MJ4 is it's a very articulate bass. It speaks very quickly. It's got a real present mid-range voice. That's what this means, mid-range. It just speaks. Check this out. I mean, both pickups are up full. I got a little bit of bass, a little bit of mids. The treble is flat. Let's check out some pick style. I've got the pickups set straight up in the middle, preamp set completely flat. Add some bottom. Add some mids. Little treble now. Let's roll a little bit to the front pickup. Let's go a little bit to the back pickup. If I put the mid-range back to flat and keep the bass and treble boosted, well, here's your classic active jazz bass funk tone. So that's your classic scoopy, funk, active J-bass kind of sound. We've got the bass and treble boosted. But this particular preamp, you know, with the 600 hertz tuned mid-range, you can dial in some mids without it getting all brittle and acky sounding, and it's not so low that it muds it up. So check this out. This again, without the mids. Sounds great. Now I'm going to add a little bit of mids. I really like being able to add some mid-range in with my funk tone because sometimes that really ultra-scooped, smiley-face EQ thing, it sounds great in a room by yourself, but then, you know, you get in there with a drummer, you get in there with a guitar player, keyboards, and you get lost in the sauce. And then you start smacking the bass too hard because you're not hearing yourself. You start turning up at the amp, and you're just creating problems at that point. But having the instrument kind of really represent the mid-range, you're there. You're in the mix. You're not getting buried at that point, and that's very important to me. I've taken this bass out on a lot of gigs and some really high energy, high volume things, and man, it's like the buck stops here. You are not burying me on this axe. To illustrate my point, first I'll play a little bit without mids, and then I'll dial some in. Thank you. hope you've enjoyed this look at the G&L MJ4. I'm just going to come right out and say it. I love this bass. I've been playing it on gigs now for several months, and it just makes me happy. It does everything I want a jazz bass to do, and it does a whole lot more, and it does it all really well. Now let's take into account that this is 100% US built. It's made in Leo Fender's last factory in Fullerton, California. And the suggested retail price on this is $1,700, which means the street price, you're going to see these going for between, say, $1,250 and $1,300. For a US-built instrument of this quality that performs this well, it sounds this good, man, that's a good deal. That's a good deal.